late, the markets have been unusually firm. But let's not forget that economic activity has started to pick up and we are running ahead, not counter-cyclical to the economic activity. Which is why I'm saying that we may be overheated, but we have not yet reached a bubble status yet. So I don't think the balloon is going to burst suddenly at this point in time. If there are any telltale signs appearing, I will definitely record another video to that effect. But at this point in time, you must always, always be careful and look over your shoulder for that vicious correction at any given point in time, even though it doesn't look imminent. It pays to be careful, and do remember before you put in any harsh comments that when I say be cautious, it does not mean be bearish. I'm just saying be cautious. Cautious does not mean bearish. All right. You must always be cautious because there's money involved, and losing some amount of your money means that you have to make up for the lost time just to come to ground zero. And we don't want to waste time losing and then bringing yourself up to ground zero again. You want to go to positive territory all the time. So at this point in time, stay invested, hold on to your blue chips, good quality stocks. We aren't hit a bubble status yet. And if possible, avoid very aggressive leverage buying. Do not overextend yourself on borrowed money. And leverage is borrowed money, unless you are a professional trader, a professional risk taker who is trained to know what he or she is doing in the market. Veterans are okay to take a leverage risk or even stack their investments one after the other. But retail investors should stick to a cautious path of taking deliveries and sticking with them.